I started a company when I retired from the tour, Sold Instinct, and my wife and I started a company called Solitude. We're one of the first surfing companies to be involved with sustainability. This was like 20 years ago. And we located our offices right across the way from a place called Rincon, one of the most famous waves in the world. So no matter how good a wave pool is, one day I'd love to see the spiral in a wave pool, the spiral concept. It's just every surfer sees that and their mouths start watering. When the surf's good at Rincon, you can ride for about nearly a mile. So the same guy, Glenn Henning, who'd phoned me up so many years before with Surfrider, phoned me up again. He said, Shaun, your adopted home break is facing a severe environmental challenge. All the homeowners of those multi-million dollar homes are connected up to septic tank systems. When it rains, the water table rises, the septics overflow, and the crap flows out in the river, and I want to do something about it, and I want you to help me. He said, you've got a $100 budget. I said, Glenn, this is a $30 million problem at least. He said, no, we're going to solve it with $100. I went, well, what can we do? He said, I'm going to bring the media, I'm going to bring the government officials all down to the beach. He said, and we're going to bring a group of kids down, 100 kids, and I want you to give them something to inspire them for $100. So I went home that night, and I thought, you know, what can I do? Maybe I can give them some Solitude gear. And then I thought, no, I'm going to do something different. And I promise you, what I did next, I will unequivocally state, changed the path of my life and has helped millions of people transform their lives too. So what I did, I picked up a pen and I wrote 12 lines, every line beginning with I will. And I wrote it in 20 minutes and I called it Surfer's Code. 12 lines, every line beginning with I will. I'll never turn my back on the ocean. I will always paddle back out. They weren't commitments to be the best surfer in the world, or they were just about leadership. They were about values. They were about positivity. They were about resilience, about courage, about honor, the basic building blocks of life. And I printed up 100 little plastic cards, and I gave them out to the kids that came down to the beach the next week. Kids loved the cards. Parents loved the cards. And ultimately, we got a groundswell going. We solved the environmental problem, but the cards just kept on going. People loved the cards, and we started putting the cards in the pocket of our clothing. We were making lots of clothes back then, and hundreds of thousands of these cards were getting distributed out into the culture. And eventually, I started getting invited to people to talk at events about a code and about a surfer's code. People were fascinated with surfing and a concept of a code. So I started speaking at huge organizations. Big ones, Google, Cisco, all of these, the big guns, and I'd speak with Malcolm Gladwell and Richard Branson, and I just talk about a code, about surfing, about spreading the stoke. And then at an event, I met a guy, and we wrote a book together, and I called it Surfer's Code, and it was an exploration about every single one of these 12 lines.